من التزم السلفية حصل الخير كله، وحصل أجرا عظيما وفيرا كبيرا، لأنه لزم هدي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، أما بعد، الحمد لله after a period of time we haven't had any lesson. بفضل الله تعالى we were able to begin today with the second foundation, أصل الثاني. أصل الثاني, the second foundation being, as Shaykh Islam Muhammad Abdul Wahab mentions, أمر الله بالاجتماع في الدين ونهى عن التفرق فيه. فبين الله هذا بيانا شافيا تفهمه عوام، ونهانا عن نكون كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا قبلنا فهلكوا، وذكر أنه أمر المسلمين بالاجتماع في الدين ونهاهم من التفرق فيه، ويزيده وضوحا ما وردت به سنة من العجب العجاب في ذلك. ثم صار الأمر إلى أن الاشتراك في أصول الدين وفروعه هو العلم والفقه في الدين، وصار الاجتماع في الدين لا يكونه إلا زنديق أو مجنون. This asl, this foundation, as mentioned by Shaykh Islam Muhammad Abdul Wahab, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded wajtima' coming together and unity upon the deen, and has prohibited for us tafarruq. He has prohibited for us the affair of tafarruq, splitting and differing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has clarified this in a clear and concise manner, to the extent that the lay person will be able to understand. And He, Azza wa Jal, has prohibited us from being from those individuals that have split and differed. To be from those individuals that have split and differed, like those that came before us, and as a result, were destroyed. And He, Azza wa Jal, has commanded that we unite upon the affair of the deen, upon the affair of the religion. And He prohibited us from splitting in our deen. And we find even more clarity in this affair by what is found within the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that makes it even more, that increases the clarity in more of an amazing manner. And then the affair of iftiraq, splitting, became usul al-deen. Then after some time, the affair of splitting was then regarded as being usul al-deen, the foundation of the religion. Now, so the affair of, from the affair of splitting in usul of the deen and the furu' of the deen, in the usul, the foundation of the religion, and the affair that split off from those foundations was regarded as being ilm al-fiqh fi al-deen, was regarded as being knowledge, al-fiqh fi al-deen, understanding in deen. Whilst ijtima' fi al-deen, coming together and unity in deen, was not something that was said except for what is indeed all imaginable, except for the one that was regarded as being the heretic, or the one that was regarded as being insane. And so this is the second foundation. And so Shaykh Ahmed al-Najmi, rahimahullah, he says in his commentary, لقد قرن الله عز وجل الأمر بالاجتماع في الدين وعدم التفرق فيه بالعبادة وهو من العبادة. فقال جل من قائل: إن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاعبدون. وفي الآية الأخرى: وأنا ربكم فاتقون. And so, Sheikh begins by mentioning that this command of ijtima' fi al-deen, coming together in the deen, and adam al-tafarruq, and not splitting, this is an affair of ibadah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it along with ibadah. As he azza wa jal mentions, indeed this your ummah is one, the ummah of one, and I am your Lord, so worship me. And another ayah, I am your Lord, so fear me. ومفاد هاتين آيتين ما يلي. Now what should benefit from these two ayahs? The following. هو أن المعبود والله فلا تجوز عبادة لغيره. The first is that the معبود, the one that the worship is directed towards, that's Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And so, it's not permissible to worship other than him. وكذلك لا بد أن تكون الأمة واحدة مجتمعة على هذا الحدث وهو وحدانية المعبود وأنه هو الله وحده لا شريك له. And likewise, it's a must that the Ummah is one and united upon one goal. And this is this affair of singing Allah Ta'ala alone in his worship. That he, Allah Ta'ala, is alone without any partners. فوحدة الأمة بأن تكون الأمة واحدة آخرة من ربها عن نبيها صلى الله عليه وسلم الأوامر والنواهي تتلقى عنه الأوامر والنواهي بواسطة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم لما جاء في الكتاب والسنة فتعمل بها. ولهذا أخبر صلى الله وبهذا أخبر سبحانه وتعالى أن هذا الذي بينه لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو الشرع شرع لكل الأنبياء والأمم وعلى رأسهم أولو العزم كما قال جل من قائل: شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. فأخبر أنه وصى بذلك نوحا أول الرسل ووصى به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو آخر الرسل في قوله والذي أوحينا إليك ووصى به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى وهؤلاء الثلاثة المباقون من أولي العزم إبراهيم الخليل وموسى الكريم عيسى ابن مريم روح الله وكلمته التي ألقاها إلى مريم. And so, the Shaykh, he goes on to say, and the unity of the Ummah, that it's one Ummah, it's one nation, that takes from its Lord, from its Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the commands and the prohibitions, and they take from him the commands and the prohibitions by way of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that which is taken and that which is found within the book and the sunnah, and acts upon it. And so due to this, he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is informed that this affair, that he has clarified to the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a unity. This is what has been clarified to all of the Anbiya and all of the nations. At the head of them, the Ulul Azm. Anbiya known as the Ulul Azm. As Allah Ta'ala has informed us, that has been prescribed for you, indeed, that which we had revealed and prescribed to Nuh, that which we revealed to you, and with that which we have revealed to Ibrahim and Musa and Isa, that they establish the deen and do not split by way of it. So he informs subhanahu wa ta'ala that he's revealed and he has advised وجزافات to Nuh. And Nuh was the أول رسل, was the first of the messengers. And he advised with the to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he is the آخر رسل. And he is the last of the prophet, last of the messengers. Nuh was the first of the messengers. Was Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was the last of the messengers. When he mentioned سبحانه وتعالى والذي أوحينا إليك, and that which we have revealed to you. And he revealed it subhanahu wa ta'ala to Ibrahim and Musa and Isa. And these are the three remaining from those anbiya referred to as the Ulul Azm. Ibrahim is the Khalid. And Ibrahim, the close friend or companion. Musa is the Al-Kalim, the one that was spoken to directly. Was Isa ibn Maryam was the Ruh al-Kalima. He was referred to as the Kalima alayhi salam for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him upon one Kalima. Kun falyakun, be and he was. Faqawluhu an aqimu al-deen ay lillah. So his statement to establish the deen, meaning to establish the deen for the sake of Allah. وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. I do not split by way of it. هذا عمر بأن يقول الدين لله تجتمع على ذلك الأمة. فإن حصل في ذلك الخلاف فتقول العوضة إلى الله ورسوله فيما حصل فيه الاختلاف. وعندئذ يحل الاختلاف بما أمر الله به في قوله وما اختلفتم فيه من الشيء فحكمه إلى الله ذلكم الله ربي عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب. And so this is the command of Allah تبارك وتعالى that the Ummah is united upon one affair. And so if anything occurs from اختلاف, anything occurs from different, then they return to Allah. They return to Allah and they return to His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in that affair they have differed about. And at that time, the differing is solved. It's solved by way of that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded. In His statement, and that which you have differed about, then His judgment is with Allah. That is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, your Lord. That is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, my Lord. And upon Him I have trust, and to Him I submit. وفي قوله ولو ردوه إلى الرسول وإلى الأولي الأمر منهم لعلمه الذين يستنبطون منه. And if they were Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if they were to return the affair back to the messenger, and the one that given authority from them, لَعَلِمُهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِتُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ, then indeed they will know that who those that extract the rulings from them. ولقد خص الرسول على اجتماع وعدم التفرق بل إنه قضى على كل أسباب التفرق واختلاف ومن تعمل أحكام شرعية يجد أن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في تشريعاته التي تلقاها من ربه لم يدع سببا من الأسباب التي تؤدي إلى الاختلاف إلا وحسمه امتثال لأمر الله حيث يقول وَأَتَتَمُوا بِحَمْدِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وقال سبحانه وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوا ولا تتبعوا سبلا فتتفرق بكم عن سبيلي ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تتقون. And so you find that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم specified this affair of اجتماع coming together in unity and not splitting. Rather, he would judge upon affairs to ensure that this did not occur, that splitting difference did not occur. And so the one that upon the rulings of the Sharia that defined that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his legislation, that he legislated, brought about by legislation, that he taken from his Lord, that he did not leave any means for them from the means that will lead to differing, except that he has removed it. And he adhered to the command of Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, when Allah Ta'ala commands, hold on firm the rope of Allah, be not divided, and Allah Ta'ala stated, and this is my straight path, so follow it. Na'am. وقوله يزي ويزيده وضوحا ما وردت في وما ورد ما وردت به السنة من العجب العجاب في ذلك. أقول الأدلة في السنة منها قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم نذر الله إمرأة سمع مقالتي فوعاها وحذف وحفظها وبلغها فرب الحامل فتح إلى من هو أفقه منه ثلاث لا يغل عليهم قلب مسلم إخلاص العمل لله ومناصحة الأئمة المسلمين ولزوم جماعتهم فإن دعوة التوحيد من ورائهم ومنها قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أتاكم وأمركم جميعا على رجل واحد يريد أن يشق عصاكم ويفرق جماعتكم فاقتلوه ومنها حديث افترقت اليهود على 71 فرقة وافترقت النصارى على 72 فرقة وستفترق هذه الأمة على 73 فرقة كلها في النار إلا واحدة قالوا من هي يا رسول الله قال هم الذين على مثل ما أنا عليه وأصحابي إلى غير ذلك من الأدلة أسو الشيخ أحمد النجمي رحمه الله He goes on to mention now some of the adilla found in the Sunnah for this affair of ijtima' ala al-haq, coming together upon the haq, coming together upon the deen, establishing the deen of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala for his sacred home and upon the unity. As he mentioned, rahimahullah, the hadith of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, found the Sunnah in the Tirmidhi. That Allah Ta'ala illuminates the face of an individual, they hear the statement of mine. And he takes it in, he memorizes it, and conveys it. Or perhaps the one that carries an affair of fiqh understanding will convey that to one who is of great understanding in him. And three affairs prohibit the heart being covered. The heart has also been covered. Ikhlas, sincerity in action for Allah. And advising the Muslim leaders and adhering to the Jama'ah. And likewise, we have the narration that when whoever comes from to you with an affair, for one individual, one man, however he intends to split your group, then kill him. And the hadith where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states that indeed the Yahud, the Jews have split into 71 sects, and the Christians and the Nasara split into 72 sects. And this almost went to 73 sects, all of them in the fire except for one. And so they said, who are they, O Messenger of Allah? And so he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they are those that are upon that which I am upon today. And other than that from Adilla, the Shaykh mentions, there is other than that from Adilla, from truths. وَقَالَهُمْ ثُمَّ صَارَ عَمْلَ الْإِفْتِرَاقِ فِي وَصُولِ الدِّينِ وَفُرُوهِهِ وَالْعِمْ وَالْثَبْتِ الدِّينِ وَصَارَ إِجْتِمَاعَ فِي الدِّينِ لَا يَكُلُ إِلَّا تَنْدِيقُ وَمَجْنُونَ And so the affair became that the command or the affair of iftiraq splitting in the foundation of the religion or the affairs that project from those foundations, this was now then regarded being ilm, true knowledge and self understanding in the deen. And so And the affair of ijtima' fi al-deen, coming together and unity in deen, was not stated except by the zindiq or the majnun. Was not stated except by way of the heretic or the one who was majnun. لعل مقصود المعلم فيما حصل بين المسلمين من الاختراق في أصول الدين وفروعه فالاختراق في أصول الدين حصل كثيرا فمن جهمية إلى اعتزال إلى قدرية إلى مرجع إلى غير ذلك. So the مقصود, the intent of the اختراق in أصول الدين وفروعه, the اختراق, the splitting in أصول الدين, in the foundation of the deen, is something which has happened plentifully. So you find that you have splitting by way of the Jahmiyyah or i'tidal, al-Mu'tazila, or the Qadiriyya, or the Murji'a. These are all splitting in the Usul al-Din, in the Aqeedah, in the Creed. وكذلك افتراق في الفروع. Likewise, an افتراق in the affairs of the فروع, يعني different splitting in the affairs of fiqh. As the Shaykh goes on to mention, this in some more detail. He says, فمن حنفية إلى مالكية إلى شافعية وإلى حنابلة وظاهرية. وهذا افتراق في الفقه الإسلامي لا يعد افتراقا بل هو مجال للتنوع الأفهام واختلافها أو اختلافها في المسائل التي يصوب فيها الاجتهاد وليس هذا بعيب ولا نقص ولكن العيب والنقص هو الترك الدليل قول الإمام هذا هو الذي يذم صاحبه ويلامه. As the Shaykh mentioned, when we're discussing iftiraq in the furu', iftiraq in the affair that branch off from the usul, branch off from the foundations, then it's in discussion of the affairs of fiqh. So you have the Hanafiyya, you have the Malikiyya, you have the Shafi'a, the Shafi'iyya, the Hanabila, and you have the Zahiriyya. And he says, in iftiraq, there's differing and splitting in the Islamic fiqh. However, this is not something which is regarded as being splitting in Islamic fiqh. Rather, there is room and there's a means of there being difference of opinion and difference of understanding in different affairs, in different issues. And this is all based upon the ijtihad of المؤفقي والعالم. And so there's no aim in this, there's no shame in this affair. And there's no lux, there's no deficiency. However, the shame and the deficiency occurs when the person leaves off the delil, when they leave off the proof for the statement of the Imam. This is when you have an affair which is blameworthy. And the person that does this is to blame. ولعل المؤلف رحمه الله قصد إلى هذا الاختلاف وأن كثيرا من أهل زمنه قد ذهبوا إلى أن من ترك هذه المذاهب وأخذ بالدليل اهتهموه بما وصف المؤلف من الجنو وزندقة وزندقة هي عدم الاقتراف بالدين وعدم المبالاة به والعياذ بالله. And so Sheikh Ahmed, he goes on to say, Rahimahullah, that it is assumed that the intent of the Mu'allif, the intent of the author, the Sheikh al-Islam, Muhammad Abdul Wahab, his intent when referring to the ikhtilaf in the furu', or ikhtilaf in the fiqh, is that many of the people of his time, they had held the opinion that whoever left off any of these madahib in favor of the delil, then they would accuse him with these descriptions of junoon, insanity, or zandaqa, heresy. While zandaqa, the Shaykh mentioned the zandaqa, this is someone that has no importance to the deen and turns away from his deen, the deen in reality. Wa Allah تبارك وتعالى أعلم ونكتفي بهذا القدر إن شاء الله الحمد لله ونذهب تفكير الأصل الثاني بإذن الله أن المجلس يكون في الدرس وفي الأصل الثالث بإذن الله تعالى جزاكم الله خيرا.